Hello guys, hello everyone. This is Rashid Khan from LPM Public School Gola Bazar and class 7. Now we have to go through the chapter number 5, that is acid and acid bases and salts. This is the chapter in which some remaining portion are there on which we have to discuss. That is I have already told you about that the basic substance, that is basis and the present where they are present in. So in this concern, the potassium hydroxide or sodium hydroxide, both are the basis, they are present in a soap. Next is calcium hydroxide, which is present in a lime water. Now we can say the magnesium hydroxide, as the name as magnesium hydroxide. So milk of magnesia, it is the substance in which it can be found. The second one is ammonium hydroxide. Ammonium hydroxide is found in a window cleaner, the substance which is used for cleaning the windows as well. So this is a different type of bases which are found in different resources and in the different sources by which they can be found. Here some of the other important topic on which we have to discuss. Let us discuss on the topic, the properties of bases. It means what are the basic properties of the bases by which it can be determined this one is a base. In which first one, the we have to write down in this manner, the properties of basis. So we'll have to write down the properties of basis. In this concern, first one, what are the basis actually? Basis first of all are the substance. Basis are the substance that test bitter. You can say these are the substance that test bitter, or you can also say the basic substances are bitter in test. So they are the substance which have bitter test. Next is, these are the slippery. These are slippery or soapy to touch. When it is touched, it feels like a slippery or soapy. As example, when we touch any soap or detergent in which there is a basis, so by the touching itself we can know about what is the actual the feeling of soap, what are the feeling of the slippery and soapy. Next one is, these are the mineral base, you can say the alkalis base. Alkali bases are, you can say the strong bases. Alkali bases or strong bases are corrosive in nature. This is the property through which it can be identified, determined. Why? Because they are known as the corrosive in nature. Why? Because they are very reactive, or we can say the very strong. So in this manner we have to move on to the next one. What it is? The bases generally react with acid. When bases react with acid, it forms what? A neutral substance. When it reacts with acid, then it forms a neutral substance. These neutral substances neither basic nor acidic. So what are actually they are? They are neutral. So on that basis we can say these properties, the neutral properties of any substance is the difference from the acid or bases. That means neither they be tested as a acid, neither they will behave or they are in nature as a base. So they are very different from the acid or a base. Why? Because it is said to be either when they are reacted with the acid, so it will form the neutral substance. These neutral substances you can know very well. The salt solution, and you can say the common salt, the salt solution, or sugar cane, cane sugar, or glucose. These are the substances which can be a neutral substance. We have to go through the next one. What are the neutral substances? So here we have to move on the topic called as neutral substance. The neutral substances are those the substances which neither are those that do not have an acidic or a basic behavior. Or you can say the properties of acid or base. Or you can say these are a substance which neither acidic nor basic in nature. They are called as a neutral substance. That means neither it is basic nor acidic. So these are the neutral substances. These neutral substances are what are these? The neutral substances are. Neutral substances are what actually? They are common salt. Sugar, that is a cane sugar, and glucose. These are the example of a neutral substance. Common salt, then cane sugar and glucose. These substances are termed as what? The neutral substance. So for these neutral substance, this is sufficient enough. We'll have to move to the next topic. The next topic is that is indicators. Indicators. What are the indicators? You have seen in the vehicles, there are indicators that inform about you have to slow down or you have to completely you have to completely stop. In case of the road, you can see wherever the stops. There are the three type of signals, that is the indicators, that indicates either you have to go slow, either you have to stop, either you have to move on with a steady movement. So here is another indicator that gives the information. It is tells us about how is the substance is, how the substance is. That means whatever the substance given, that is acid or base, it has to be clear. So for that instant information, we have to use acid or a base indicator. So these indicators are what? The indicator which give the information about that the given substance either in basic or acidic in nature. For those, we have to know about acid taste sour and basic taste bitter. So basis taste bitter. So many acids and bases, however, cannot be tested. बहुत सारे ऐसे एसिड और बेस हैं जिनको हम लोग टेस्ट नहीं कर सकते, लेकिन बहुत सारे टेस्ट हो जाते हैं. तो अगर हम टेस्ट सबको करने लगे, टेस्ट कौन सा है, बीटर है, सॉर है, तब हम इस नतीजे पे पहुंचेंगे. लेकिन जिनको हम टेस्ट नहीं कर सकते, उनके लिए क्या करेंगे? देयर इज अ इंडिकेटर. सो वी कैन से द टेस्ट वेदर द सब्सटेंस इज एन एसिड और बेस, दे कैन either they might be corrosive. So what will happen? For these instant information, we have to go through an indicator. We are going to now use the indicator for those such type of a substance. So we can say the indicator is a special substance. The indicator is a special substance that can, that changes the color in presence of acid or base. It is the indicator that can change the color of an acid or a base. And we can say that already these are the substance, these are the substance that can use as a chemical substance, either they may be acid or a base. Or we can say the indicator is a safe way to know about or to determine if a chemical is acid or a base. Now we have to go through, we have to move on. What are these indicators? Are the indicator that tells us about the different type of acid and a base by testing it itself. So in this concept we have to move on. What are these natural indicators? Are these natural indicators are turmeric, the litmus paper, and red cabbage, and the China rose, that is gudal. So these are all the natural indicators. What are these? We can say the indicator first of all. It is a special substance. It is a special substance. It is a special substance that changes its color in presence of acid or base. It can only the things that can change its color in presence of either acid or base. What are these natural indicators? Natural indicators are natural indicators are first of all China rose, that is gudal, red cabbage, and litmus paper, and China rose, litmus paper, red cabbage, and turmeric. Yes, turmeric. So how we can say this? These are the things that's good. That's okay, no problem. But litmus paper, how is the litmus paper is the natural indicator? Why? Because these natural indicators are derived from the lichase. These lichase are what? It is the natural substance by which this indicator is prepared. So it is called as a natural indicator. So this is all about the natural indicators. Or indicators. So we have to move on the dyes. Dyes as a natural indicator. Litmus paper. Let's see what is the litmus paper. Litmus paper. What actually the litmus paper is? This is the most commonly used indicator. This is the most commonly used. This is most commonly used indicators. सबसे ज़्यादा common use होने वाला कौन सा है? ये है आपका litmus paper. और ये बनता कैसे है? It is extracted from extracted from the plants called lichase. From lichase, and this can be different types. We will get to the next video.